In this lesson, the objective is to analyze the graph of a polynomial function. And here, we are going to be looking at certain concepts which are involved in polynomials and their graphs. If I have this polynomial function, the following statements are true. That's what it means by equivalent. The zeros, k is the zero of the polynomial function f. If I have k, then I can write this factor, x minus k, and the solution is k, whichever the k, the zero, is the solution when you equate the polynomial to zero. And if k is a real number, then the x-intercept is going to be k. So the end behavior of a polynomial is the behavior as x approaches infinity, that is positive infinity or negative infinity. And let me illustrate here to make sure this is clear. So if I have the xy axis, as I continue, see this is zero. If I go this direction, this is positive infinity. So this is positive infinity, and this is negative infinity. So when you see this expression right here, we read it as x approaches positive infinity. So what does that mean as you proceed in this direction? That's negative infinity. As you proceed in this direction, this is positive infinity. And what we are doing with this is looking at the behavior of the graph. When we talk about the behavior, we are talking about whether the graph is going up or going down. So let's look at some examples here. If you look at this graph in blue, as you go to the positive direction, that means as you approach positive infinity, you can see the graph is going up. So that is what it means here by f of x is approaching positive infinity. See, the graph is going up. See, as you approach the left-hand side, x approaches negative, you can see the graph is going down. And you can see the opposite is true for y is equals to negative x. And you can see here, see this graph is approaching positive infinity, as x approaches both directions. And we're going to look at more about all what you see here on this page. So in studying the behavior of polynomial functions, the most important thing is the degree. Is the degree odd or is the degree even? So the degree could be odd or even. What does it mean by an odd degree? Odd degree is a degree like x. The highest power is 3. Or you could have a power of 5. So you just look at every polynomial and check the highest power. That's what we are calling the degree. Is it odd? Is it an odd number? It could also be x raised to power 1. So all those ones, that's when you can say the degree is odd. Okay, now let me go back here and talk about the leading coefficient. If I have a polynomial, let's say 2x cubed plus 2x plus 3, and note here, the degree here is, the degree, the highest power is, I'm going to highlight that. See, this here is where you find the degree, the highest power. So here we can say the degree is equals to 3, and you can see it is odd. The leading coefficient is this number here. And you can see this number, the leading coefficient, you can see it is positive. That's all we care about. So if I had another polynomial function, let's say I have 2x minus 12x cubed, or let me use an even degree now, plus 5x to power 3 plus 8x. So this one, what is the degree? The degree is 4. And what is the leading coefficient? Is it positive or negative? This one is negative. So those are the most important things to know here, because we are going to use those to tell about the add behavior. So now let me erase everything I have here so that I can be able to address all that. So I erase all that. And now, when the degree is odd and the leading coefficient is positive, okay, so I'm going to make a graph here. And I want you to think about the add behavior. The add behavior is what is happening at the add points. We don't know what is happening in between. It's just like somebody smiling. You don't know why they are smiling, if I could use that illustration. So when the degree is odd, the graph always is going down as you go to negative infinity, always. When the degree is odd and the leading coefficient is positive. And at the other end point, then it's going up. So it's always going to be this way. Remember, in between, we don't know what is happening. Maybe that's how the graph looks like, but we do not know. All we are looking for here is the add behavior. See, this is positive infinity, and this is positive infinity, negative infinity. And here I can write the behavior. I could say here, as x approaches negative infinity, f of x approaches negative infinity. And right now I'm describing this side here. You can see that's what is happening. And now you can see as you go to the left, the graph is going down. F of x represents the graph. And let's talk about when you approach the other side. As x approaches positive infinity, so where am I going? I'm going to the right. Remember, this is left. And here I'm going to the right. And when I'm going to the right, where is the graph going? F of x approaches positive infinity. And this happens all the time. And what are the conditions? When the leading coefficient is positive and the degree is odd. Something I want to emphasize here, something which can help you remember. See, when it is odd, the end points are pointed in different directions. And you can see on the right, it goes up. Let's we can go back here. What an example of such a polynomial would be, let's say 2x cubed plus 5x plus 3. You could have like 7x to power 9 plus 3x. So all those ones, they are not going to look exactly the same, but the add behavior is going to look the same. The add behavior, even for a linear function like this one, the add behavior is going to look the same. Those are some examples. At another example, what about when the degree is odd? Okay, now let's look at a degree which is odd and the leading coefficient is negative. Remember, the leading coefficient is negative. So let me make a sketch here. So how is this going to be different? Remember, we know it is odd. So when it is odd, we know it's going to be pointing different directions. It's going to be pointing different directions. So here, That's how the graph is going to look like. So that's how the head behavior is going to be. Remember, we don't know what is happening in here. We just know about the head behavior. That's where our focus is. Remember, here we are going to positive infinity, and this is negative infinity. So this is positive infinity. This is negative infinity. Let's now describe the head behavior. So we are going to say as x approaches, I always like to start from the left, f of x, what's happening to f of x? Where is it going? It's going up. So positive infinity. And as x approaches positive infinity, what about f of x? It is approaching negative infinity. So that is the head behavior. When the degree is odd, the leading coefficient is negative. And we can give examples of such functions. So 7x to power 3 plus 3x minus 4, that's negative. Minus 2x to power 11 plus 2x plus 3. What do they have in common? The leading coefficient is negative. The degree is odd. So those are some examples. Okay, now let's go to this one. So here the degree is even and the leading coefficient is negative. So how is that this going to look like? If I sketch it, see, when the degree is even, the endpoints point the same direction. And what examples do I have for this before I write the head behavior? I could have 2x cubed, no, not cubed, because I want the degree to be even. 2x squared minus 4x minus 8x to power 4 plus 3x minus 4x. Remember, what we are concerned with is the degree. It has to be even, and we are also concerned with the leading coefficient. It's negative. So when that is the case, then the graph is going to be going down and going down. And remember, we don't know what is happening in the middle. That's how it might look like, or it might look something like this. We do not know. All we know is the head behavior. And I want you to think about, for these ones, when the leading coefficient is negative, think about a parabola. See, it always opens down. And I always think about when, because it's negative, it's like a, this is like a sad face. It's negative, it's like a sad face. You can use that to help you remember. Okay, so let's describe the head behavior. As x approaches negative infinity, what do you say about the graph? F of x approaches negative infinity. As x approaches positive infinity, f of x approaches negative infinity. See, the head points are pointed the same direction. So that's the head behavior when the degree is even, when the leading coefficient is negative. Okay, now the leading coefficient, the degree is even, leading coefficient is positive. And even before I describe it, I want to remind you something you did in algebra. If you have a parabola and the leading coefficient is positive, it's always opening up. And the way you can remember this is remembering it's positive. Oh, it's a happy face. Happy face. It's positive. Okay, now let's go here. And how is this graph going to look like? The leading coefficient, the degree is even. So the degree is even. So if the degree is even, see, this is going to be opening up. We don't know what is happening on the inside, but it's going to be pointed like that. So let's write here the air behavior. As x approaches negative infinity, the graph is going up to positive infinity. As x goes to, as you approach the right-hand side, the graph is going up, or is approaching positive infinity. That's how we read it. Examples of such functions would be 2x to the power 4, 2x to the power 4, plus 3x plus 9, 8x to the power 6, plus 3x plus 8. Those are some examples. Okay, now, and you can see the summary of everything we did there in notation form. Okay, now let's look at an example here. What do you think is the leading coefficient of this polynomial? Did you say positive? What do you think is the degree? Is it odd or even? So it's pointed different directions. So it has to be odd. What are the zeros? So I see negative 3. And zeros are just the x-intercepts. Then I have 2 and I have 6. And what will be the equation in factored form? So the equation would be x minus negative 3. So that's x plus 3, x minus 2, x minus 6. So that's the equation in factored form. The air behavior, we just described it, so we're not going to do that over here. Now we look at another one. So what do you think about this one? What do you think about the leading coefficient? See, the leading coefficient, it's adding the, on the right-hand side, it's going down. So that has to be negative. The degree has to be odd. It's pointed different directions. The zeros are the intercepts. And what are they? Negative 4, 0, and 4. And what is the equation in factored form? So we get x minus negative 4, so which is x plus 4. This is x minus 0, so which is just x, and then x minus 4. So that will be the equation, and you can describe the air behavior. Okay, here we have another one. So note that the edges are pointed the same direction. So the leading coefficient, it's opening up, so it's happy. So it's going to be positive. The degree is even. They are pointed the same directions. The zeros are minus 5, 2, I mean negative 2, then 1, then 3. How about the equation? The equation would be x plus 5, x plus 2, x minus 1, x minus 3. So that's the equation. And we can describe the air behavior. And what about this one? If you don't have the graph. So what do I know about this one? The degree is odd. And what about the leading coefficient? There's a number next to the x squared. See, there is a 1 there. So I can see it's positive. So what will be the air behavior? I could sketch it. I know it's going to be going down there, and going up, and going down, going up. So I can describe the air behavior. X approaches negative infinity. The graph is approaching negative infinity. And as x approaches positive infinity, f of x approaches positive infinity. Okay. Now, what about, and see, this is the graph, the actual graph when you graph it. See, we are concerned with the add points, the add behavior. And we can see when we graph it, you can see this is the accurate graph. That's how it looks, right? Okay, now what about this one? This one, the degree is 4, which is even. And what about the reading coefficient? The coefficient of the highest degree, of the variable of the highest degree, it's negative. So what does that mean? See, it, since it is even, I know it's going to be pointed down. So I can say as x approaches negative infinity, f of x is going down, approaches negative infinity. And even as you approach the other side, the graph is approaching negative infinity. So that will be the add behavior. Okay, and if you graph it, see how it looks, right? That's how it looks, right? Okay, here, what about if you're told to graph this function? And all we are given is the zeros. So let's start with the zeros. What are the zeros? The zeros are negative 2. You just flip the sign. And this is x is equals to 1. Since it is squared, see, this is a repeated root. So it's a repeated root multiplicity of 2. So this is one of the zeros. And the other one is x is equals to 1. And see, this is repeated. What else do I know? I have squared. So x times x squared. So the highest exponent is going to be 3 by multiplying the x's. The reading, so the degree is odd. That I know. The reading coefficient, I can see it's 1/4, and I see it's positive. So how does that help me? I know the graph is going to be going down, and I know here it's going to be going up. And I know since this is even, I know here it's going to be bouncing off. So I need to, let's get some more points. If I plug in 0 into this equation, what do I get for y? So y is going to be 1/4 times 0 plus 2 is 2, and the other one is times 1 when I plug in 0, because it's going to be 0 there and 0. So this is 1, 0 minus, so that'd be negative 1 squared. So this becomes 2 times 1, so that's going to be half. So that's going to be 0.5. So actually that one is going, is that's how the graph is going to go. I'm just making a sketch here. Then let's plug in negative 1. So this is if x is 0. So if x is equals to negative 1, what do we get? 1/4. Negative 1 plus 2 is just 1. Negative 1 is 4/4. See, that's how you can graph a polynomial when you are given the zeros. And let's gather. When you graph it, see the way it looks like. Right? When you actually graph it, like in decimals or in a calculator. Let's go to the previous one. See, remember this one has 2 zeros. So the degree is 3. And then it's going to be 3 minus 1. So it has 2 turning points, and you can see them here, and then you can see it has 2 zeros. And here, let's talk about the turning points. So the turning points correspond to the local maximum and maximum minimum. See, this is a turning point for this graph. This is another turning point. And for every graph, the maximum number of turning points is n minus 1. And some polynomials may have less than that, but if all the zeros are real, then it's going to exactly have n minus 1. And okay, and if we go to this one, what would be the maximum number of turning points? So the n is the degree, which is 4. Then we do n minus 1, which is equals to 3. And when you graph it, see, this is how it's going to look like. One turning point, another one, and another one. So a turning point, like I just said, is the maximum or minimum. Look at this one. And here we have another one. I mean, this is the graph. Look at this one. See the same one we had. It's the same one with the local maximum. See the turning point? And you can see the zeros. They are all there. You can see them on the graph.